So I hope I'm audible and visible. Please give me a thumbs up if my audio video is all clear. Please give me a quick thumbs up, everyone, if my audio video is clear. Yes. So welcome to the next session, that is Let's Crack NEET PG. And today we will be discussing a very, very important topic, and that is the questions related to the eczema. Now, a little bit of my introduction. I'm Dr. Cheshta Agarwal, your NEET PG educator on an academy. And I've myself scored All India Rank 261 in my entrance examination. Now we are currently going on with some of the offers on an academy, and what are those offers? So just a second. Yes, if you use the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT, you will get an additional 1% off if you get a 3-month subscription. So I request all of you to please get a 3-month subscription so that you can avail a 3+1 offer. The next is, we have a very limited period offer going on right now, and that is the Iconic subscription, which give you an access to both an academy and prep letter. If you use my referral code Dr. Cheshta YT, and if you avail the 3 years of Iconic subscription, you will get an amazing discount of 58,500. Very important. If you avail a 3-year discount of a 3-year subscription of an academy using the referral code, it becomes around 58,500, which is around 1,000 rupees or 1,200 rupees per month. So I request each and every one of you to please go ahead and get an academy subscription. We have around 34,000 questions on an academy platform. So I request all of you to start practicing, download the an academy app and subscribe to the Unacademy. There are many batch courses going on right now. For example, Target Next batch, FMG Test and Analysis batch. Then we have NEET PG batch course and INICT batch course. Whatever suits you, I request all of you to please become a part of it. Okay. Now, starting with the first question of the today's session, all of you please answer this question. A 4-year-old boy with the itchy papules on the forehead and the exposed part of the arm and the legs for 3 years. The disease was most severe in the rainy season and it improved completely in the winters. Similar history in his younger sibling, what is the most likely diagnosis? Anyone? Very nice. So a 7-year-old boy with the itchy excoriated papules on the forehead, the exposed part of the arm and the legs for 3 years, and the disease was more severe in the rainy season and improved completely in the winters. The correct answer of this question is option number 1. So just a second. It is a classical case of insect bite hypersensitivity because it says that the disease gets completely improved in the winter. Now, how does atopic dermatitis present? Please remember, all of you, atopic dermatitis will never present like this. The presentation of atopic dermatitis is somewhat different from what is given here. Now, before going ahead and discussing the atopic dermatitis, I would like to tell everyone that what is the exact feature of the eczemas, how does they present? So you have an acute eczema, subacute eczema and chronic eczema. Acute eczema will have oozy lesions. Subacute eczema will have scaling and crusting. And chronic eczema will have lichenification. Now, what are the features of lichenification? You have 3 features. Skin thickening, you have increase in pigmentation, and you have increase in skin markings. So these are the three types of eczemas which are present. Now, eczemas is also broadly divided into exogenous and endogenous eczemas. The exogenous eczema is of three types: contact, phytophoto, or photodermatitis. Now, please remember, in case of exogenous, the cause of eczema is present outside the skin. For example, sunlight. For example, pollen grains. For example, allergens. So all those factors which are present outside the body and which is giving rise to any form, acute, subacute or chronic, it is called as exogenous eczema. While endogenous means problem lies inside the body. For example, in seborrheic dermatitis, we have increased activity of the sebaceous gland. In pityriasis alba, we have defective skin barrier. And in asteatotic dermatitis, we have defective odolent bodies giving rise to dryness of the skin. So endogenous means factor lie inside the body. And exogenous means factor lies outside the body. Now remember that in atopic dermatitis, you have both the features, exogenous as well as endogenous features. Quickly give me a thumbs up if everyone is agreeing with this. Please give me a quick thumbs up if all of you agree with this. Any confusion? Yes or no, any confusion? Yes, very nice. Just a second, I think I'm not visible. Am I visible to all of you? Please give me a quick thumbs up. Yes, I'm visible to all of you. Very nice. Now coming to the atopic dermatitis. Atopic dermatitis is one of the manifestations of atopy. What do you mean by atopy? There is presence of asthma, allergic rhinitis and atopic dermatitis. Now atopic dermatitis is a purely clinical disease, which means that you should have clinical presentations. What is the exact pathogenesis? As I have told you just now that it is both exogenous and the endogenous. What are the endogenous features? There is immune dysregulation. And what is the exogenous feature? You have skin barrier abnormality. The exogenous feature is called as outside in theory. And the endogenous feature is called as inside out theory. So please remember this, all of you, that atopic dermatitis is a feature of both exogenous and endogenous. The exogenous feature is because of defective skin barrier, there is more and more entry of allergens and pathogens into the skin. And because of immune dysregulation, you have hyperactivity or you have hyper response of the disease function. Now, what are the clinical presentations of atopic dermatitis? It presents with three symptoms or three stages: infantile phase, childhood phase, or adult phase. Starting with the infantile phase. The infantile phase extends from birth to 2 years. Now what happens? There is mainly involvement of the extensors. For example, there is involvement of elbow, knee. There is involvement of the cheek with classical sparing of perioral. Can you see? Classical sparing of perioral and periocular area. This is called as infantile phase of atopic dermatitis. Second is the childhood phase. In childhood phase, you have extension of the disease from 2 years to the puberty. And here you have mainly flexural involvement. Understood or not, all of you? So you have a infantile phase where you have extensor involvement and childhood phase where you have flexural involvement. And if at all you have involvement of the face, the perioral and the periocular region will be involved. So both these areas will be involved in the childhood phase. And the third is the adult phase, which progresses or starts from puberty. And here also you will see flexural involvement. Clear or not, all of you, please give me a quick thumbs up if you understood the three stages. That is infantile stage, which goes up to 2 years. Childhood phase from 2 years to puberty. And adult phase is puberty onwards. In the infantile phase, it is mainly the extensor surface involved. While in childhood and adult phase, it is mainly the flexural areas which is involved. I hope this is clear to each and every one of you. Very, very important for your entrance examination. Now coming to the diagnostic criteria of atopic dermatitis. Atopic dermatitis is a pure clinical diagnosis. What do you mean by this? It means that you do not require any investigative modality for diagnosing the atopic dermatitis. Merely looking at the clinical presentation, you can tell that this is a case of atopic dermatitis. What are the criteria? You have major criteria and minor criteria. And we will be discussing each and every one of them one by one, starting with the major criteria. The major criteria are four. The first is itching, which is considered to be the hallmark. And it is said that if itching is absent, you have to rule out the atopic dermatitis. Clear or not, all of you? So please remember that the atopic dermatitis itching is a hallmark. Second is typical morphology and distribution, which we have just now read. Either it should be infantile stage with extensor areas involvement, or it will be the childhood phase, or what is the next one? The adult phase. The third is chronicity. It means that the disease should be present for a very long duration. So that is called as the chronicity. And the third is there should be a positive family history of AtoP. Now for making the diagnosis, you should have itching plus any of the two out of the three major criteria should be present. And in case of minor criteria, you should have itching plus three minor criteria which are available. Now comes what are the minor criteria. The first is dryness of skin, which is also called as ichthyosis. The next is denim organ fold. Look at this image. Can you see this? The extra fold which is present just below the lower eyelid, this is called as the denim organ fold, which is seen frequently in the patients of atopic dermatitis. Third is the headlight sign. The hypopigmentation around the eyelids as well as around the nose, around the forehead. Can you see? This is called as headlight sign, which occurs because of abnormal or persistent vasoconstriction. Clear all of you?
Yes.
The next is palmar hyperlinearity. Now I'll zoom the image for all of you. Can you see this increased skin marking over the palmar skin? This is another minor criteria which is seen in the patients of atopic dermatitis. So the one was dry skin, then denim organ fold, then headlight sign, you have palmar erythema. The next is the ocular features. Anterior subcapsular cataract and keratoconus. So what is keratoconus? Can you see this coning the anterior margin of the cornea becomes cone shaped. So this is called as the coning or the keratoconus. Other is pityriasis elba. Can you see this hyperpigmented lesions? Here, here, here. This is called as pityriasis elba. And then you have periocular hypomelanosis. Can you see periocular increased pigmentation? Very, very classical of atopic dermatitis. Very, very classical of atopic dermatitis. The next is, yes, the recurrent skin infection, very frequently seen, increase in IgE response, and lastly is white dermographism. Look at this image. This is called as white dermographism. Usually we tend to see red dermographism, but in atopic dermatitis, because of persistent vasoconstriction, you tend to have presence of white dermographism. Next is Hertogi sign, that is loss of lateral one third of the eyebrow, also called as Queen Anne sign. An antenna sign, which is nothing but follicular keratosis. Okay, so these are some of the findings of atopic dermatitis. This is the flag sign, and this is the madarosis or the Hertogi sign, which is the loss of the eyebrows from the lateral part of the skin. Now, how to make the diagnosis? As I've told you previously also, you have purely clinical diagnosis. Itching plus two major or three minor criteria makes the diagnosis. How will you treat a case of atopic dermatitis? The very important point is prevent the precipitating features like excessive soaps, dry skin. This should be avoided. You should give lot of emollient because it helps in improving the skin barrier. You can give topical steroids and even topical tacrolimus in these individuals. Okay? You can give topical steroids and topical tacrolimus in these individuals. There are many recent drugs or biologics which are available, like dupilumab, nemolizumab, ustekinumab, lebrikumab. Another very important biologic is crisaborole, which is the phosphodiesterase inhibitor. And it comes in the topical formulation. Now, one point is the topical steroid is always given during the active stages of the disease, while topical tacrolimus is given during the chronic stage. That is for the maintenance. Very, very important, because you cannot give steroids for a longer duration as it can cause the skin changes like atrophy and many side effects. Now, starting with few questions, I want all of you to please answer the questions related to atopic dermatitis. Everyone, please answer the question, all my dear students. We have around 10 students live with us. I request all of you to please answer the question. Anyone? So a 3-year-old child with the itchy eczematous lesions on the extensor surface, please remember it is a case of atopic dermatitis. So remember, itching is must, and along with that, two major criteria, that is distribution and a history of atopy, will make the diagnosis of atopic dermatitis. And this is in accordance with Hatchkas, Rajkas and Hennepin's criteria. Anyone? What is the characteristic feature of atopic dermatitis? Anyone? Yes. Venkateshan? Anybody else want to answer this question? Please remember, the characteristic feature or the hallmark of atopic dermatitis is pruritus. So the answer becomes option number one. Very nice, Madhu, Mishba and Venkatesh. Minor clinical feature in diagnosis of atopic dermatitis are all except. Very nice, Pallavi. I request all the students to please subscribe to Unacademy using the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT. Please subscribe to Unacademy. Very nice. The correct answer of this question is, all of the following are the minor criteria except pruritus. Because pruritus is a major criteria. Consider as the hallmark. Yes, very nice. Very nice, each and every one of you. Very well done. Spongiosis is seen in. Very nice. Spongiosis is seen in acute eczema, lichen planus, psoriasis or pemphigus. Yes. So spongiosis is nothing but intercellular edema. And intercellular edema is a feature of acute eczema. Clear, all of you? Clear? What is the commonest site of atopic dermatitis? What is the commonest site of atopic dermatitis? Mishba, Venkatesh, Madhu, Harika, Pallav. Yes. The correct answer is, now if you remember, I've told you both in childhood phase, and adult phase, flexures are frequently involved. Both in childhood phase and adult phase, flexures are involved. Okay? And that is why the anterior cuboidal fossa becomes the commonest site of atopic dermatitis. So with this, we are done with the today's session. I hope everybody have enjoyed. This was a very short session. Please give me a quick thumbs up, all of you, if you like the today's class. We have done many of the questions related to atopic dermatitis. I request all of you to please subscribe to Unacademy using the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT. And please join to Unacademy because currently I am going on with the plus course. Mishba, I request you to please join plus course on Unacademy if you have not done it before. And I will request you to go with iconic subscription if you are planning to buy Unacademy subscription. Because currently we are going on with actually a very, very cheaper price right now. So please go ahead and buy the iconic subscription using the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT. Don't waste time in thinking. If you are seriously planning, then go ahead and subscribe to Unacademy. So bye-bye all of you. Take care. We'll meet again. From tomorrow onwards, we'll having two classes, one at 8:30 p.m. and another is 12 p.m. Today there is no 8:30 p.m. class because we have a plus course which will get clash with that. So from tomorrow onwards, we'll have again the same thing, the two sessions, one in the morning and one in the evening. And we will be starting with the discussion of anatomy as well very, very soon.